Hello friends, this is Supriya Mogle. I am working as an assistant professor at Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. So we are going to learn today market targeting. Okay, in the previous video we have learned market segmentation. The next part of this STP model is market targeting. So we'll see what is market targeting. Market targeting is an act of developing measures of segment attractiveness and selecting one or more market segment to enter. So in previous video we have learned that suppose this is a market and we are going to divide some parts which are having similar needs, okay, and after dividing the parts as per various basis, then we target one particular segment, one or more particular segment, that is called market targeting. Okay, but question arises here, how to select effective market? There are four criteria for selecting a market. First is measurable. The market should be measurable, means marketer has to measure some factors like income, purchasing power or size of the market. So it should be measurable. Then sustainable, substantial. Substantial means market should be that much sustainable where marketer should get profit from that market. Accessible, easily access to the customers. It should be access easily. Differential means your product or service should be innovative and new so that you can select a proper market. The next is selecting market segment. How you are going to select the market segment? There are five types. First is single segment concentration, selective specialization, product specialization, market specialization and full market coverage. So we are going to learn in detail. First is single segment concentration. So what is single segment concentration? Here marketer select one segment, cater one product to the selected market. So in this diagram you can see here M1, M2 and M3. This is your market, okay, your market. And P1, P2, P3 are your products. Okay. Are your products. So, what it has said, single segment means you are going to have only one product and one market. Okay. This is your product and you are going to sold in only one market, that is M1 market. So, for example, tractors for farmers. So, tractors are only sold for farmers in the single market. So they are focuses on the farmers only and they are producing one product, that is tractor only. Okay, single state segment concentration. Next is selective specialization. Selective specialization, that is, refers to select few segments objectively which are lucrative and matches with objectives set by organization and fit with the available resources. In simple word, you are going to produce more than two products, P1, P2, P3, three products for three different markets, means you have produced a P1 product for market one only, P2 product for market two only and P3 product for market three only. Okay, so this means one product for one market. Here example is suppose traditional clothes are there. So traditional clothes for Indian market, Western clothes for foreign markets. Okay, so as per market the product will be changed. So the third one is product specialization. Product specialization means here marketer has mastery in product and technology, that is single product is marketed for different markets. So here marketer produces only one product and distributed in all the market, means one product is marketed in various types of markets. For example, Coca-Cola. Okay, Coca-Cola is sold in Maharashtra also, Gujarat also, in the foreign countries also. So here is product one, but you are going to sold in various types of markets. Clear? Fourth is market specialization. Okay, market specialization. Marketer has specialization and caters product to one selected market. That is, different types of products marketed in single market. Okay, so here marketer produces different types of products, P1, P2, P3, three types of products, and sold in only one market, sold in only M2 market. Okay, they are not focusing in M1 and M3. So for example, Himalaya products. Okay, Himalaya products, there are so many types of products, like hair shampoo is there, soap or scrub, face wash, etc. And you are going to supply, or you are going to market it in the only one market. Okay, so the last one is full market coverage. Here marketer covers all the customer goods with all the products. That means various product for various markets. For example, FMCG goods. So there are various types of products, and these are sold in various types of marketing. Very simple. The next is alternative approaches to the target market selection. There are another approaches for selecting the target market. First is undifferentiated marketing, differentiated marketing, and concentrated marketing. So the first is undifferentiated marketing. It means focuses on entire market with single product and mass production. I have explained mass production. We are going to produce in large quantities. Okay, and here one market, for whole market you are going to produce only single product. For example, Maggi, now there are having some options to Maggi, but in the start it was sold in whole market, a single product was there only. Okay, then Tata Namak is the only one product which is sold in the whole market. Okay, next is differentiated market. Differentiated market means focuses on entire market with variety of products. Means this is a market and we are going to produce different types of products. Okay, one marketer going to produce different types of products. For example, Patanjali products. You know, Patanjali is only one company. Okay, one company, and they are producing different types of products, like cosmetic products are there, FNCG products are there, biscuits, or healthy products are there, or creams, face washes, soaps, etc. So company is one, but they are producing many products for the whole market. Okay, third is concentrated marketing. So what is concentrated? Focuses on few market only, but it has unique specialization. For example, Apple phone. Okay, now this is our market and we are going to target only few people. You are going to target only few people with a single product only, but this single product has unique specialization. For example, Apple phone. So Apple phone, these are produced only for high income people, right? Its price is very high. It is not affordable for middle class people. And Apple phone, the company is only focusing on high income people. They don't bother about middle class people. So this is our one single product, few customers, and whole market. Clear? Then nano car is produced for middle class only, right? Middle class people. Just like that, concentrated marketing means there is few market, but it has some special unique specializations. Okay. So I hope you understood the concept market targeting. First part was segmentation, means how we are going to divide the parts of whole market, and target means how you are going to target the market to sold our product in the market. Okay, thank you.